Isn't it funny how when someone is deemed an authority or expert in one particular field of our society, their authoritative position goes to their head and they find it necessary to speak in areas they know absolutely nothing about. Hello, my name's Jason with Pathway Ministries. I want to talk to you today about Colin Cowherd. Colin's a sports analyst and commentator, formerly with ESPN and now with Fox Sports, and he submitted a colorful rant on the two silliest things he's seen in his life. The first thing, according to Colin, is the hard stand many take against homosexuality or same-sex marriage, as he so eloquently put it. Let it be clear, there's absolutely nothing wrong in our free nation with expressing one's desire to support one issue over another as far as morality is concerned. The right to express his opinion is protected by our country's founding documents. Where Mr. Cowherd crossed the line was when he moved from expressing his opinion to speaking on a topic he has no expertise in, what the Bible says. While his opinions about sports are refreshing and many times enlightening on a human level, when he stepped into the realm of biblical exegesis, he trespassed into God's backyard and tried to rewrite the laws there. Pastor Colin, yes, you heard me right, because Pastor Colin is teaching the Bible now to thousands, so he must have went to theological college. He had this to say on what the Bible teaches about homosexuality, and I quote, "The Bible doesn't spend any more time on same-sex relationships than it does on anything else. In fact, it spends far less time on that. So those who say God says this or God says that, God doesn't spend any time on the same-sex marriage issue in the Bible, okay? So I think the opposition to same-sex marriage has been absolutely outrageous in my lifetime. The silliest thing in the world. If people love each other, they should be together, okay?" End quote. Wow. Mr. Cowherd's authoritative decree on what the Bible teaches about anything is just as absurd as if he were to show up and teach a seminar on brain surgery. While he may be an authority in the world of sports, Colin's biblical knowledge leaves much to be desired. In case you were wondering, God's Word has much to say about the sin of sodomy, homosexuality, or same-sex attraction, as it's called today. Leviticus 18:22 states, "Thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind, it is abomination." Deuteronomy 23:17 says, "There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel, nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel." 1 Kings 14:24 tells us, "And there were also sodomites in the land, and they did according to all the abominations of the nations which the Lord cast out before the children of Israel." And let's not forget that because of homosexuality and a list of other sins, like pride, gluttony, idleness, ignoring the hand of the poor, haughtiness, and other abominations, per Ezekiel 16:49 and 50, God destroyed a whole city, Sodom, from which the name sodomy is derived. There's absolutely no way any honest student of the Word of God could say that God is okay with homosexuality. Again, if Colin were to say, "The Bible is nonsense, it has antiquated ideas," he would have every right to say that. Or if he were to say, "I don't believe in God, so I don't care what God's Word says," then he would be well within his rights to say that. It's just that the moment he says God isn't against sodomy and even goes so far as to say God doesn't spend any time on the same-sex marriage issue in the Bible, Colin steps into the realm he's not an authority or an expert in. And while we are on the subject of what the Bible teaches about homosexuality, I wanted to make one obvious point most try to ignore when they debate this very heated topic. God doesn't say homosexuality is wrong because he enjoys making people feel bad. Many cast God in their mind as this hate-filled deity, standing with a huge heavenly fly swatter, just waiting for us to mess up so he could squash us like a bug. If that were the case, neither Colin Cowherd, myself, or anyone listening would be here today. Why? Because we've all sinned and fallen short of the glory and the righteousness of God. That's found in Romans 3:23. God has to have this conversation with us, that is, the conversation that we are sinners and have sinned. Forgiveness can't be offered until the offenders see their error and ask, God has grace and mercy for the taking, but those who want it must ask for His forgiveness. Jesus Christ came to save homosexuals, cheats, liars, substance abusers, spouse abusers, and any other vile sin you can think of. While I listen to Colin's sports commentary and mostly enjoy it, I feel he stepped into an area literally far above his pay grade when God, His holy word, and a Christian faith are concerned. Friends, America and this world has a sin problem, and it's expressed in many ways, homosexuality being one of them. We all need to be saved and to trust Jesus Christ for forgiveness of sins. If it doesn't work in brain surgery, it won't work in Christianity. With all due respect, Mr. Cowherd, please stick to your day job.